Hi, good morning. Once again, Sridhar here from Remax Ace Reality. I'm here to today talk about the problems which the real estate agents are facing, especially in getting brokerage confirmation. One of the comments that I received from one of the real estate agent is that whatever system that you are talking about seems to be a good advice, but it is very difficult to implement because the sellers or the buyers are not cooperating in signing up the forms, brokerage forms that I'm talking about. Okay. See, I have told you that earlier also that you need to take a confirmation from the seller or the buyer and the buyer, not even or, and the buyer. Of course, the buyer is he doesn't have to pay you brokerage in case he's buying a new property. But this is applicable to the resale property that I'm talking about. Even the tenants, who are wanting to rent out property, you need to take a brokerage confirmation from him. The first would be the WhatsApp message, where you need to get a confirmation from him. Because today, we are all dealing in online, and you are communicating to him through WhatsApp or email. So that confirmation is required, number one. Number two is the brokerage form that you need to get a signature from him. People who are hesitating to sign, you be rest assured that he will not pay you brokerage. So why do you want to do business? Now, this is what I had preached earlier. So one of the comments came saying that, like, how do we get this implemented? Okay. They are saying that they are not ready to sign up papers and all that. So tell me one thing. Why do you want to deal? Is the buyer or the seller, let us say now buyer, tell him that, sir, you are paying money to the seller. Why do you want to register the property? It's okay, no? Trust is there, no? So why don't you trust him and then just sign the, no need to sign and all that. You just pay the money, go inside and occupy the property. Do you think he will do that? He will agree to that? You need a sale deed to be done and you have to register the property. Similarly, a seller, okay, he wants to give his property to a buyer. Will he give it simply based on trust factor? Will he be able to give that property only on trust? He won't do it, right? He needs an agreement to be signed by the buyer. He needs the sale deed to be signed by the buyer. So they will both go to the registrar office and in front of the registrar, they will sign. Why this is required? It's not required, no. So, but that is different. This is different is what people will say. But how can it be different? It's a business. We are into business. Okay, you are doing business in your terms and condition by asking the buyer or the seller to sign an agreement, to sign a sale deed and all that. Why not a real estate agent who is doing business put certain conditions saying that, look, this is what is my brokerage form. Sign it and give it to me. I need to do business with you. If you are interested in doing business with me, this is my terms and conditions. Please sign it and give it to me. So what is wrong in asking about this? Why are you hesitating to ask him? The reason why these people are not signing it, first of all, is you don't ask. You go with the firm and tell him that you please sign it and give it to at least about 7 out of 10 people will sign it and give it. 3 people may not agree. But those 3 people who are not agreeing to sign and give it to you, please don't do business with them. There's no need because they will not pay you brokerage. Even if you sell tomorrow, if at all he wants to pay, he will say, Apne kya kya hai? Property to dikhaya. Rest everything I only did know. So take 10,000 rupees, he will give you. Is that enough for you? You have worked for, you have slogged for such a long time. And finally, he says that take 10,000 rupees and go. Many people are deprived of their brokerage commissions only because they are not following the systems. Okay. So in case you are in agreement with me, what I'm saying that, and if you don't have any formats of brokerage form, client registration form, property registration form, and the site visit form and all that, comment below. Ask me that question. I will send it to you. Okay. Put your email ID while you're commenting. Put your email ID also saying that, I need the brokerage form format, the client registration form format, property registration format, and the site visit form. Okay. All the 3 I will send it to you. Just change the name. I'm from Remax. So the format which I'll be sending you will be of Remax format. So all that you need to do is remove Remax and then put your own, logo or whatever you want to do. And then use that form. So if it is helpful to you, you please ask me that question. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.